I think rock climbing is where we really got to know each other. And it's where we really got to see each other in our true colors. And, you know, you're grungy and smelly and you're working together. And I had to trust him a lot because I wasn't very confident in my rock climbing or very experienced.
The time that I first realized that I wanted to pursue this girl and see if she would go for a guy like me was in Idlewild. You're constantly working as a team and you're constantly facing the unknown.
And you can't turn back, you have to summit. And so he wanted to see that we could work together as a team.
And as we were climbing the rock, I realized that this is the girl for me. I had a couple of friends go ahead of me and prepare a boat for me. I put the ring there, and so I started driving the boat out along this mile-long lake in Mission Viejo.
All of a sudden, these scuba divers come up, and they ended up passing him off this package, had in it five different color roses.
And so I got down on one knee and said, JJ, will you marry me? And I was doing that. I put the ring on her finger, and when I first saw my bride for the very first time in the wedding dress, I was just shocked that she'd be walking down the aisle to greet me and that she would be my wife. And it made me get emotional. So it made me tear up inside, which I probably haven't done for 15 years or something like that. So I think that being married feels a lot different. say the biggest reason is because there's someone always there for me, constant support, and realizing that she'll be there for the rest of my life.
We're excited. I think our kids will be tough kids, knowing their dad toughen them up so they can live up to the Klein legacy. But yeah, we're looking forward to having kids, but not right away. We have too many school loans.
Tim made everybody feel comfortable, like they were the most important person in the room, and you got Tim's full attention. And Tim loved the Lord. He was an amazing reflection of the steadiness of God. And so many times in my life, I reached out to him, and he brought the love of God to me when I needed it the most. So I'm gonna radically miss my friend.
He's always out to help other people. So everything he's doing, he's always thinking about the people around him.
Even trying to break world records for them. On Friday morning, Palmdale High School teacher Tim Klein set out to climb 1,096 laps at a Santa Clarita indoor gym. His longtime climbing buddy, Jason Wells, says it's like scaling a well-known attraction at Yosemite National Park.
El Capitan's about 3,000 feet tall, a little bit more. Tim's gonna climb 29,000 vertical feet, so that's about 9 El Capitans stacked one on top of each other.
It's also the equivalent of climbing Mount Everest. Klein wants to beat the world record of 13 hours and 25 minutes for reaching that height indoors. He's doing it for this team.
Wonderful.
Katie is a former student in Klein's Healthcare Academy at Palmdale High. She was only in his class for a semester before she was shot in the head 2 years ago, leaving her with a less than 1% chance of survival.
The doctors, they said that she was never going to make it. Look at her now where she's at, talking to everybody, you know.
Katie's family says Klein has been there for every step of her long, painful road to recovery.
He'll come see her every 2 weeks, no matter what. Till this day, he still comes. And we're very grateful for that.
Now he wants to see Katie return to school. She's nervous about facing her peers, so he's spending hours climbing up and down these walls to show her you have to start somewhere.
Have progressed into an amazing individual. So best described by many as not only a inspirational figure, but a miracle. So the community believes in you, Katie. Yeah, they're still recovering. Yeah, I know. Our largest donator doesn't know you.
Yeah.
Lives in San Diego. Has never met you yet. Learned about your story and came on board.
Yeah.
Every day is going to be a climb. Mm. But every day, I know you're going to be dreaming big. You're going to make big goals. And I want you to remember, as you put your hand on this, mm-hmm. as you start out the day, that there's a lot of people behind you. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people that believe in you. You're valued to many people. And you're going to make a huge impact. You're going to continue to make a huge impact on other people's lives as you progress.
Throughout her entire recovery, Tim provided encouragement and ultimately was inspired by Katie's strength, determination, and the will to succeed, which motivated him to break a Guinness World Record. He ended up beating the old record by almost 4 hours and ultimately scaled the gym's climbing wall over 1,000 times for a grand total of 29,065 feet. Tim used his world record attempt as a fundraiser for Katie's family. I applaud Katie for your courage, determination, and recovery, and the return to school. And I commend you, Tim, for your unwavering support of Katie. You give us all hope.
It's a great honor to be in a room of elected officials who make decisions every day for millions of people.
who also serve millions of people day in and day out. But to be honest, it's also an honor to be in the same room of a true miracle. A miracle that was told that she had under 1% chance to live. A miracle that when the doctors had to relay, after many months of being in Children's Hospital in Los Angeles County, that there's a good chance that she would never be able to speak again. A miracle that was also told that she wouldn't be able to consume food on her own. She would never be able to move her arms or her legs. A miracle that prior to coming to Palmdale High School, getting released to come to Palmdale High School, only a couple of weeks ago was deemed as a paraplegic. And I'm going to ask our miracle to now move her legs. I'd only expect to see the most, the best for her, because Katie is one that doesn't look at what is. She focuses on what could be. Thank you.
Why don't you tell Mom where your favorite uncle is?
Yeah, cool. I watched the movie.
He's definitely my favorite character.
Really?
My brother-in-law.
Okay.
What'd she say?
You are. Okay, we can go now.
Okay, go.
Tim on the head wall. Oh, yeah. And then, woo, yeah. Yeah. Woo! Yeah!
Oh, yeah. It's a perfect day. I can't tell you how many times I heard Tim say that when we were hanging from a wall, climbing or hiking. He always found the positive in every situation. He really found the positive in every person, for that matter. He was just one of the most positive and selfless people I ever knew, and I will miss him immensely. And I am a better person because of knowing Tim. And to quote Tim, it was truly a joy to have experienced a friend like you.